If you flip your plastic bottle to the bottom, you'll notice this symbol. In fact, you'll come across this symbol in many different plastic products, only with different numbers. This is called resin identification code. For each number, represents different materials of plastic. For plastic bottles, the number 1 represents polyethylene terephthalate, or better known as PET, or PETE. What exactly is PET, and how is it made? PET is produced from polymerization of ethylene terephthalate monomers. There are two ways to produce PET. The first way to derive PET is through heating up ethylene glycol and terephthalic acid, together with a catalyst. An ester of ethylene terephthalate is formed. It then undergoes condensation polymerization by linking up repeating units of ethylene terephthalate. PET and water is produced. Ethylene glycol is derived from ethylene, with two hydroxyl groups called diol. Terephthalic acid, on the other hand, is a dicarboxylic aromatic acid. Both of these compounds are obtained through process of crude oil refining, cracking, and oxidation. The second method is through transesterification and polyesterification of dimethyl terephthalic acid and ethylene glycol. This reaction will produce PET and methanol. PET is clear, strong, and lightweight material, commonly used in packaging food and beverages such as soft drink bottles and plastic jars for jams. It is also used in packaging cooking oils, mouthwash, shampoo, liquid hand soap, and etc. Microwavable containers are made from special grade PET. PET is useful for making filaments of 3D printers. For certain, PET products are everywhere. Plastic bottles and other PET products will eventually get thrown away. What is their fate then? Where will they end up? Most PET products are single use. Once used, it gets thrown away. PET is designed to be an inert material. This may sound like a relief as no toxic chemicals are released from it, but bear in mind that it is non-biodegradable. A plastic bottle can take around 450 years to decompose. Some even take up to 1,000 years. Imagine how much waste will pile up in the landfill. Plastic will not only find a way in landfill, but oceans too. Plastic waste are congested by aquatic life, including the seafood that we eat. According to scientists at Ghent University in Belgium, people who eat seafood congest around 11,000 microplastics every year. The good news is that PET materials can be recycled. Recycling a ton of PET products can save 7.4 cubic yards of landfill space. In fact, PET bottles are highly recyclable in some countries. Recycled PET can be used in automotive manufacturing, industrial applications, and fabric manufacturing, or can be simply recycled back into new bottles. Plastic waste are shredded into pellets before they can be used as feedstock to manufacture new products. This can help create a circular economy where materials are constantly being used as long as there is a possibility of recycling, recovering, and regenerating. Circular economy for plastic is a massive opportunity towards a more sustainable and resource-efficient future as it rules out reliance towards crude oil for plastic production. There are other alternatives to PET, such as bio-PET, PEF, PTF, PLA, and PHA, which are derived from renewable resources. Most of these materials are not yet readily available on the market. Hopefully, a new revolution of food packaging will open its eyes in a few more years. PET is cheap. It is the most economical packaging type, as businesses can keep their product at low cost. Yet, much is needed to be done to decrease the environmental effect of PET waste. Consumers should develop a recycling habit, and recycling technologies, facilities, as well as services need an upgrade to ensure that circular economy can be a reality. Thank you. For more information, check out these websites.